red light on? Okay, this is a feathers test. It's on an aileron wing. Ready? What makes this interesting is it makes a aileron wing feel like a polyhedral wing. I can turn it with rudder, without which an aileron wing would not do. But those feathers out on the tip actually turn this into almost the same effect. So here's aileron, let's get it going. Here's a roll with ailerons. Here's a roll with rudder alone, but see, it's still on an aileron wing. So here's a roll with ailerons. Two ways, let's do it again. Roll right, roll left. Motor is off, and actually my hands are off the transmitter right now. It's just finding its own neutral point. Rolling to the left a little bit, which I can trim out of it. Okay, let's bring her up. It has a roll like that. Roll back, but I've got rudder and aileron mixed on this. Just for the sake that it's easier to trade wings. Now I realize that doesn't look like a bird, but by the time I'm done with it, the tail and the wing will be modified to. Plus, birds don't have red stripes across the middle. But that's just gliding in. This is a pelican with just feather-like attachments to the wing. Very stable. Now it's in a windy day, so it's here kicking around a little bit. Can see the effect here. Let me bring it in and we will trade out the wings. That. Now this is the polyhedral wing with tip feathers. It's just gliding, finding its own center here. I'm not necessarily flying it, I'm just letting it float around. But the tip feathers make it even more sensitive to rudder. If I give it some throttle here and hit rudder, the rolls are more aggressive than you'd normally have with a plane with tips on it. Has a little bit more rocking in it, but that's expected if it's doing its self-leveling. It's actually taking care of itself. And this is just rudder elevator. There's no ailerons on this one. Oops. Here, I'll go. I'll hit it again. Don't film my rear end.